Welcome back to the channel. I'm really excited about this one today. We have a lot to cover, but we're talking about the provisional ball. I'm going to break down when you're allowed to play a provisional ball, how to properly announce that you're playing a provisional ball, and finally, we'll wrap up with what you need to know as a player when playing that provisional ball out on the course. So there's only two situations when you're allowed to play a provisional ball. The first situation is if you think you've hit your first ball out of bounds, and the second is if you think you've hit your ball in an area where you can't find it, aka it's lost. But it has to be lost outside of a penalty area, and that's a key component of this rule. If you know or think that you've hit your ball into a penalty area, you're not allowed to play a provisional ball, and in those situations, you must proceed with taking the appropriate penalty relief. Let's put the drone up in the air to put this in perspective. So here we are on the par 5 eighth at my home course, Skybrook. You can see the green at the top of the screen, as well as a popular landing area in the fairway off the tee. Now we have a couple of things going on here on either side of this fairway. If you look on the right side, outlined here, this is not out of bounds, nor is it a penalty area. It is simply a part of the general area. Now, technically speaking, there is a penalty area to the right side of this, and it might be difficult to tell from this vantage point, but this penalty area is so far right, it is virtually unreachable. I have never once in my 7 years seen anybody blow a ball that far right that they were able to take penalty area relief. In fact, I didn't even know this penalty area existed until I filmed this video. Anyways, this general area can get pretty nasty because our superintendent is a sick and twisted human being who likes to grow this area up to about waist high during the summertime. So it becomes a very popular place for people to lose their ball. So if I were to hit a ball into this area, which I can clearly see from the tee, and I fear it might be lost, then I would be allowed to play a provisional ball because the ball is potentially lost outside of a penalty area. But if we look on the left side of this fairway, that is not the case. All down the left side, there is a red penalty area. If I were to hook my ball left and towards this penalty area, and I know or think that the ball could be in the penalty area, then I would not be allowed to play a provisional ball. Because the only reasonable place where the ball would be lost if I were to get up there and can't find it would be in the penalty area. Therefore, a provisional is not allowed. So now that we know when we're allowed to play a provisional, let's talk about a very commonly overlooked step, which is announcing that you're playing a provisional. So as a player, you must properly announce that you're playing a provisional ball. And this can really be done in one of two ways. Number one, actually saying the word provisional. Or number two, clearly indicating that you are playing under Rule 18.3, the provisional ball rule. Saying phrases like, "There's no way I'm finding that," or "That ball's out of bounds," or "I'm gonna play another one," or "I'm gonna reload." None of these phrases constitute properly announcing the play of a provisional ball. If you don't properly announce that you're playing a provisional ball, even though that you and everyone around you knows that your intent is to play a provisional ball, then what you think is your provisional ball actually becomes your ball in play under penalty of stroke and distance. Even if you get out there and find your first ball and you want to play it. I will add this though, in the back of the rule book, there is an interpretation that covers this concept. And it cites that if you say, "I'm going to play another one just in case," the rules of golf would honor that as correctly announcing play of a provisional. But that "just in case" verbiage is really important. Nonetheless, just say the word provisional. It's not hard. It's one word. We all know it. And saying that key word will eliminate any potential controversy and you'll be in the clear. Say it with me. Provisional. I want to also add this. Even though it's not part of the rules, it is highly recommended that after you announce play of a provisional, that you identify what your provisional ball is, either by brand or model or number or some unique marking that you've put on the ball, because that could play a really key role in a bonus provisional rules tip that we'll cover at the end of this video. All right, so now that we know when we're allowed to play a provisional ball and we know how to correctly announce that we're playing a provisional ball, let's talk about how you actually play a provisional ball on the course. And for that, we're going back to the drone.
So we're back in the sky and I just blew my first ball right into this general area indicated by ball A. I think it's lost and decide to play a provisional ball, only this time I don't catch it that great and I pop it up. So my provisional ball lands here indicated by ball B. Now, for pace of play purposes, the rules of golf are not going to require you to walk 60 yards past your provisional ball to look for your first one, to ultimately not find it and have to walk 60 yards back to play your provisional. So as a player, you are permitted to hit your provisional ball as many times as needed, as long as your provisional ball is equal to or further away from the hole than where your first ball is estimated to be. So yes, I could theoretically top my provisional ball two or three times and continue making strokes at that ball without it losing its status as a provisional ball, as long as that ball is equal to or further away from the hole than where your first ball is estimated to be. Continuing on here, let's say I hit my provisional. It still remains my provisional, and there are two situations when my provisional actually becomes my ball in play. The first is if my original ball is lost. So I've hit my provisional, I've walked over to where I think my original ball is, I can't find it, my 3-minute search time expires, my original ball is now deemed lost, and my provisional becomes my ball in play under penalty of stroke and distance. So in this example, I'd be hitting 5 with my provisional. And the second situation when my provisional becomes my ball in play is if I make a stroke at it when it is closer to the hole than where my original ball is estimated to be. So let's say for whatever reason, I get distracted or I'm not thinking clearly, I forget to look for my original ball and I hit my provisional ball again. Because it is closer to the hole, as soon as I make a stroke at that provisional ball, it instantly becomes my ball in play. Again, under penalty of stroke and distance, so I would have hit my 5th shot with my provisional. And this is true even if after I make that stroke, I remember to go back and look for my ball and I find it. That original ball is now considered a wrong ball and must not be played. So now let's talk about the two situations when you must abandon your provisional ball and play your original. The first situation is easy. If I find my original ball anywhere on the course outside of a penalty area, I must abandon my provisional ball and play my original. And the second situation is if I find my ball in a penalty area or I have virtual certainty that I've hit it into a penalty area. Now this might sound a bit confusing because we just got done talking about how you can't hit a provisional if you know or think you've hit it into a penalty area. But this part of the rule is designed to cover those situations when a player hits their ball in an area and they're not sure if it's a penalty area or not. So say for example, I'm playing a course for the first time and I hit my ball into the woods. I'm not sure if it's a penalty area or not, and from the tee, I can't see any stakes or other markings. So I play a provisional ball. As soon as I get close enough to the woods and realize it is in fact a penalty area, I must abandon my provisional ball and play my original, either by playing it as it lies in the penalty area or taking appropriate penalty area relief. And that, my friends, is how you play a provisional ball from start to finish.
All right, so here is your bonus rules tip about a provisional, and it's a good reminder of why it's so important to mark your golf ball. So imagine this scenario. You step up on the tee, and you block it way right into the woods, which is where we are right now. So here's your first ball, okay? From the tee box, it looks so deep into the woods that you're not gonna be able to find it, so you decide to play a provisional ball. You go to your bag, you pull another ball out of the sleeve that you were playing, and you don't mark it. And you're still fuming about that first shot, so when you get up there to hit it, you end up hitting an identical shot, a big slice to the right into the same woods where your original ball was. So you get up here and you can only find one of those balls. But because you didn't mark it and there's no other identifying feature, you can't determine whether that's your original first ball or your provisional ball. So under the rules of golf, it says that you can play this ball, but you have to play it as your provisional ball, which would be under stroke and distance. Now here's another scenario. The same exact situation unfolds. We've got our provisional ball here. It's in the same general vicinity, but we find both balls. Again, we cannot determine which ball is which one's original, which one's provisional. The rules say that you get to choose which ball you can play, but whatever ball that you choose must be played as a provisional, which again would be under stroke and distance. And whatever ball you don't choose would be considered a wrong ball. It's out of play. You got to pick it up, put it in your pocket, and move on.
All right, so I hope you found that video helpful. If you learned anything new, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up. It really helps the channel out. And don't forget to subscribe for future rule breakdown videos. If you have any questions about today's rule, feel free to drop a comment down below. I'll get right back to you. But until next time, mark your ball.